along the lines of pagan traditions, we were wondering a little bit more if you could talk about the concept of the duality of the god and the goddess in Wiccan tradition.
Okay, that's kind of one of my favorite subjects because Wicca is about balance. It's not about patriarchy or matriarchy. It's about the sharing of power and responsibility between the genders. It's one of the reasons why the Aquarian Tabernacle Church will not take on an affiliate that is a single gender. There are some feminist groups who insist that that it's about only women, and it's not. Historically, the people who were put to death were pretty equally spread between men and women.
How wonderful!
And that was they were all pretty much. If you read Triumph of the Moon, you realize that they were all pretty much Christians anyway. People who were put to death. That's a whole nother subject, and an interesting one. But it's not about changing hats. It's about having two people in charge and balancing your masculinity with your femininity and vice versa. To claim anything else is to subvert the whole concept of Wicca, which is about balance.
So along the lines of balance and unity, we've noticed that the concept of the circle really pervades a lot of the religion, and I'd love to hear your thoughts on that particular emblem as it applies to Wicca.
Well, there's lots of symbolism behind circle, not the least of which is that everybody in it is equal. It's not necessary for you to have an ordained priest or priestess, for instance, to interact with your god. Or gods,
yeah,
and that the elimination of that intermediary makes it a personal religion, and it also makes it burdens you with a responsibility to be responsible in your behavior. Somebody else isn't going to tell you, "Well, okay, you're sorry for doing that, so you're off the hook," and you can get back in line to go to heaven. It's about personal responsibility and not about forgiveness. Forgiveness is great, but it's not if it's a license to go out and do the same thing again.
Right.
This religion is about getting a handle on both your own inherent goodness and your dark side. And dealing with them and balancing your behavior and putting that dark side energy to some purposeful use rather than just going out and stealing a car and going to confession and stealing another car next week.